Hello folks, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to create custom chatbots for Teams which will auto-respond queries based on data saved in Microsoft lists. So stay tuned and let's go to the demo after this short intro. I am in Office 365 landing page. From the left hand menu, I will click on the list app icon. This will take me to Microsoft list page. Now from here, I can create a new list. I've already created a issue list, but I can just quickly show you how to create a new one. So you click on new list and then you select a template, which is issue tracker in this case. And then you just click on use this template and give this a name and save this list to one of the SharePoint site, and the list will be created. So I've already created this list. I will just click on that list. So in this list, there are two records. I've also shown the ID of that list here as well. So by default, the ID will not appear here. So what you can do is you can go to all items and edit current view, and then you can select the ID column and then make the position from left to number one. It will appear on the view. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a custom chatbot for one of Microsoft Teams, and then when someone query and status about an issue, that person needs to provide an issue ID, so the chatbot will automatically retrieve the issue title and the status of the issue and reply back to that person in the chat window. So let's go back to the Teams. So here I will create a new team. I will create a team from scratch. I will just create a private team and I will give it a name. I will just call it issue resolution team, create. I can just skip adding extra members for now. Now the team is there. What I need to do is I need to click on these three ellipses next to this stream icon, and then I need to look for Power Virtual Agent. This is a quick and easy way to create chatbots for Teams. So I will click Power Virtual Agents, and what you can do is you can just right click on it and then pin this Power Virtual Agent here for future reference, so you can reuse it if you're creating another team bot. We'll pin it. So what it's saying is empower employees one chat at a time. So give people access to help they need 24/7, automate frequently asked question and common business processes for HR, service desks and more. So I will click on create a chatbot. I will click on start now button. Now the first thing it will ask me that which team this chatbot will be published. So we know we created this general resolution team, so I will say this team, and then I will click continue. Now this will set up things for us and it will create a default chatbot with default instructions pack which we can update, and I will show you how we can update them in a while. Now it's asking me to give this chatbot a name. I'll just call it issues update bot, English language by default. Click on create. Now my first chatbot is created. I can go and author the topics for this chatbot. I can test it and I can publish it to my team. So to test it, what I will do is I will track between topics. So I will switch this on. This will take me to the topic which this bot is when someone is sending a message. So if I say hi and enter, now this automatically engage a topic from the chatbot which fulfill this hi command. So you can see that trigger phrases are hello, hello agent, hi, or anything like that. It is sending these three messages. So to me it look like a lot more messages than we want to send. So we can just delete, select. Also we can just select this and delete this message. And here what we can do is after hi, we can get a person name who is requesting this. So we can target that person name. So if I click on this variable drop down, user display name. So we can say hi, the person name, I'm virtual agent, I can help you with. I'm just changing the message here. So what I'm saying is hi, person name, I'm a virtual agent, I can help with issue center query. So if I just click on save from the top, now that message is saved. Now if I send again, if I just say hello again, now this time it will just say hi Rashid, that's the person who's raising requests, and I'm a virtual agent, I can help with the issue center query. Now the next bit we want to do is if someone saying that I want to get an issue update, we should be able to retrieve the issue title and the issue status from the Microsoft list which we've just created. So to do that, I will go back from this back button, and then here all the topics are listed here. So I can click on new topic. So I'll click plus new topic sign here, and the name is, we'll call it issue query topic. The trigger is issue update, issue status. So I will leave these two for now as a trigger phrase. Now to author this chatbot topic, I will go to authoring canvas. So go to authoring canvas. Okay, so by default it's just sending a message. We don't want to send a message yet. What we want is we want to add something in between. So what we want is when someone say issue status, we ask a question. So the question we will ask is we will get the issue ID from that user. I'm asking question, what is the issue number? So the person needs to provide an issue number. So this will be a number column. So if I scroll down and I select number, and the variable by default, it will create a variable. So I can just change it to var issue number. That's the variable name. Okay, so it will get the issue number from the user and save in this variable. Now let me delete this for now, and then the next one we will call an action. Now this is where we will use the power of Power Automate to get the issue status from Microsoft list. So call an action. So I will create a flow, launch Power Automate. Okay, it's saying that if you leave this page, you will change, it will be lost. Are you sure you want to leave? So cancel. So let me save this first. So I will click on save. Whatever information you already put in here, you just save that information, and then you click on plus sign, and then you call an action and create a flow. So this is going to take you back to Power Automate page where you can create flows. So it has three default templates: Power Virtual Agent flow templates. I will just click on that template for now. Okay, so Power Virtual Agent is expecting some kind of input field. So we know that we are providing that issue tracker number, that as an input. So if I select a number, I will just say issue number. Yeah, so that will be the field we'll be providing via our chatbot to Power Automate, and then this is where it will return the value, which is title or the status. Then I can do is I can click on this plus sign to retrieve the record. So we'll say add an action. So what we need is we need to get a record from Microsoft list. So for that we will use get item SharePoint action. So click on that, and now we need to provide a site address. So if I just quickly show you, this is sitting on the KeyPoint training site, the issue tracker list. So we will select that site, and then the list name was issue test, and the ID we will get it from the issue number which the user will provide in the chatbot. Click on issue number. Okay, so next we got this item from Microsoft list. We need to return the value to the chatbot. So if I select this, add an output. So the first output we want is the title of the issue. So I will select a text box. I will just call it issue title, and then I will select title from this get item. So we'll get the issue title there. And another output I will select again as a text output, and then I will use issue status here. So the next output is issue status, and now we know that the status value column from the issue tracker Microsoft list is the column which we want to retrieve here. So I'll say status value, and I will click save. Now what this is doing is it is getting the issue number from the chatbot, and then retrieving the item from Microsoft list, and then returning the title and status back to the chatbot. So we have done this workflow. I will click on save now just to make sure that everything is saved. Okay, now if I click on this back, go back to previous page, click on that. This is taking me back to that chatbot page. Now we know that we have already done the trigger phase, and we ask a question, then what we need is we need to call an action. So now this time if I click on call an action, because we have already created a flow using that flow template, it is asking us to attach that flow to this chatbot. So I will click on this. Now remember that we have an input column which is issue number we need to provide to this flow. So it is asking me which variable I want to use as an issue number. So we will be using this variable because this is where we are asking the user a question, and user is replying with the issue number which we are saving here. So if I just click on select a variable, var issue number, yeah, and Power Automate will output these two variables here. So if I click on plus sign, now we need to show this message to the user. So I will click on show a message, and in this message what we can do is we can insert those output variables from Power Automate. So if I do issue title and then go next line, and I will do issue status. So I will just type in issue title, text, and issue status front of this variable. Now this should work. So if I click on save, now we can test this information. So we have that tracker on. So the trigger was issue status, issue update. What if I say, can you please give me an issue update? And I'm asking that question. Now you can see that that trigger has started. It is asking me what is the issue number, and if I go back to the list, we got the ID 1 and 2. We will say that 2, for example. So I will provide the issue number and hit enter. Now this will run the workflow and retrieve me back the issue title, which is team permissions issue, and issue status is new. So if I go back, I can see that it is a Teams permission issue and the status is new, that nobody taken over this issue and resolved it. Now we are happy with this topic. You can add as many as other topics you want. You want to retrieve other information about the issue, or you want to see who this issue is assigned to, when this issue was created, how many issues are pending, how many issues are resolved today, for example. So you can run all those queries using Power Automate workflow and using the get items function of Power Automate to retrieve Microsoft list records. Now I'm happy with this. I can just go back, click on the back here, and then I can click on this publish icon here on the top, click on publish. This will publish this chatbot to team. So this is giving me a message: an upgraded license will soon be required to publish bots using premium flow connectors and skills. For if you are using the premium connector in Power Automate workflow for chatbots, you will need to upgrade to the premium license. I'm not using any of that, so I'll just click on publish here. Publish latest content, click publish. Your latest content has been published. This will become available to your user within the next 15 minutes. So once the bot is published, the next step is you need to open this bot in Microsoft Teams. So I will click on it and then I will click on add. This will add the bot. So now I can start interacting with this bot. I can say hi. It's already sending me that message. I'm just saying, can you please update me with the issue status? It will say, what is the issue number? I will say this time one. Now it is telling me the issue title is SP not working and issue status is new. And if I go back to the issue list, that's the issue title and the status of the issue is here. So now you know that the issue update bot is available here in this left hand menu. What you can do is you can right click and pin this bot, so you can always come back to this bot. So if I go back to the Power Virtual Agent and chatbots, click on chatbots where all the bots will be available. So the one which we have just created, if I click on it, you can make any customization to it and you can publish it again. So if you want to share the bot with the team, you can click on share the bot. Before I just open it for myself, now you can just share it with the whole Microsoft Teams. So click share the bot. This will open up a window here. Now you can either submit for admin approval or you can just add it to team. This is the team we selected when we created this bot. So I will just click add to teams. So it's saying your bot is not available to your colleagues in that team. So the chatbot will be added for all the team members to use. So in today's video, you have learned how to create custom chatbot using Project Auckland Power Virtual Agent, and how you can update the topics and how you can customize the topic and add Power Automate workflow to query data from Microsoft List and answer to user query using the chatbot. Thank you for watching this video. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel by pressing the red subscribe button below this video and click the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of my future videos as I upload new videos every week. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. If you have any question regarding this topic or any other query related to Office 365, put in the comment section below. I review my comments on a daily basis. I will be happy to answer. Thank you.